Intel has been making fast and reliable desktop Wi-Fi kits for years. The idea behind a Wi-Fi kit is that anyone, including someone who doesn't know what a Wi-Fi kit is, can add Wi-Fi to their desktop computer. There are plenty of desktops that don't come preloaded with Wi-Fi. Those that do either have it embedded into the motherboard itself or installed via a Wi-Fi card. If you don't have Wi-Fi, it makes sense that you'd go to Intel's new Wi-Fi 6 Gig Plus M.2 DT kit. Being built with Wi-Fi 6 technology means that it can support wireless internet speeds up to a theoretical maximum of 2.4 gigabit per second, which is roughly 3 times faster than traditional Wi-Fi 5 tech, which only supports a theoretical limit of 867 megabits per second. Because it's built with Gig Plus technology, it's also around 50% faster than standard Wi-Fi 6 kits too. In other words, it's packed with a lot of speed. Now, you don't need to have a fully Intel-powered system to take advantage of their Wi-Fi kit, but it certainly wouldn't hurt. And this increased speed means that using your new faster Wi-Fi for competitive gaming isn't out of the question either. Intel's new Wi-Fi 6 Gig Plus kit is easy to use, but if you don't know your way around a motherboard, it can be a little daunting. There are a lot of slots and sockets and wires and plugs, and most of them don't even have anything to do with Wi-Fi. So don't worry, we're here to help. Here's a step-by-step guide showing you how to install Intel's newest Wi-Fi kit. First, you'll need to expose your motherboard, because that's where the kit's gonna be installed. You may need to remove the side panel of your desktop case. As long as you don't have too many PCIe expansions already plugged into the computer, like multiple graphics cards or sound cards, you shouldn't have any trouble finding the right open slot. That brings us to step two. You're going to need to find your open M.2 slot, which is typically located near or around your PCIe slots. It looks a little like this, and some newer motherboards may have several of these. If you're having trouble finding it, be sure to consult your motherboard manual to confirm that it has an M.2 key E slot to begin with. There may be more open M.2 slots on your board, but they may be keyed specifically for memory and therefore won't work with Wi-Fi. There's also a chance your motherboard covers its M.2 slots with thermal protection. You can just remove it following the user manual instructions for your motherboard. After finding the slot, simply plug in the kit's chip. It should make a light click when secured, and it shouldn't require too much force to plug in all the way. So if you feel too much resistance, stop, take a second, line it up, and try again. When it's plugged into the slot, tighten the small screw included with the motherboard into the proper hole, and we'll move on to the next step. The final step of this process involves installing the antenna and antenna slots, which you'll notice now dangle freely from the inserted chip. Probably not good to leave it that way in your computer. This process is identical to installing any new graphics or internal sound cards. All you have to do is detach one of the slot covers on the back of your case located here, slide in the antenna portion of the kit, and screw it down. When it's securely in place, simply screw in the antenna, and you're all set. The entire process shouldn't take longer than 10 minutes. But if you need to take extra time to consult your case or motherboard manuals, you should probably do that. Intel's new Wi-Fi 6 Gig Plus M.2 DT kit, as well as their many powerful processors like the Core i7 or i9, can be found on Newegg using the links below. For Newegg Studios, I'm Juan Carlos Bagnell. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll catch y'all on the next one.